All right, friends, welcome back to End Time Church. That is Christopher Anderson, and I'm Christopher Manti. Too many Chris's in the house, but that's okay. It kind of looks like Captain America back there, doesn't it, with that little backdrop?
Kind of a little bit, yeah.
Virtually. Yeah, not our actual rooms. That would be weird. But anyway, so we are here, and this is kind of a different one tonight. I just wanted to apologize in advance for anyone who got an email. They didn't know what it was about. Not really even advance. I already apologized already to some folks. Yes, it was from us. If you got an email that you didn't recognize, but it says End Time Church, create a login or verify your email, stuff like that. Yes, we did that. Okay, I'll explain it in a minute. It's not a problem. It's just all part of this technical little makeover that we're in the middle of. So do not worry. Do not be concerned. It's not spam. Don't unsubscribe if you see it. It's okay. Even if you do, it's fine. No worries. Okay, Mr. Anderson, how are you? I'm glad your electricity's back. You had a problem. You said, was it last night?
We had that snowstorm come through, that winter storm, and about 3 in the morning, we lost power for a little while. So I tend think to sleep late, so as soon as it clicks off, I wake right up.
Yeah, that's nice. Yeah. I think we got 0.3 inches.
Yeah.
And and then rain, so it all went bye-bye in the morning. So no, I don't have a real story for you. That's just what happened. But yeah, the kids already have had 2 snow days for no reason. But that's all right. We're getting back into the swing of things, right? That's the way things used to be.
That's right.
Kids in school and then staying home. It's all good. So anyway, man, we wanted to hopefully get as many folks as we can tuning in tonight on every platform. But if you're on the new endtime.church, you can, if you don't say, wait a minute, where do I chat? Before we get into anything else, you should know that in the upper right, if you're on our website, not YouTube or Facebook, in the upper right corner, if you hover over it, there's a little icon and it says show comments. If you hit that and you log yourself in, you can just chat and it'll show up on the video itself. It's pretty wild. Anyways, so we'll go through all that stuff. But if you're missing it, that's where it is. And on our homepage, you'll still see the same basic stuff, just in a different place. Okay. I know it's a little off-putting for some folks. But the Lord is good. He is in this. I've been like in the bunker the past week and a half of nerdland and, you know, websites and computers and figuring all that stuff out, but praise the Lord, it worked. I'm like, you know what? We'll just try it Monday. Don't fret. Let's just try it. So it's working so far. Amen.
Yeah, it looks pretty neat. Definitely different.
Thank you. Well, God bless you, Isaac. Isaac, I was just reading about the original Isaac today in my Bible time. Yes, sir. He's a good man. And hope you're well. If you have any prayer requests, now is the time, friends. If anything is going on you need prayer for right this second, do it. Put it right in wherever you're watching. Hey, Miranda, she's on our existing ETC app. Bless you. What a talented artist that young lady is.
Oh, yeah.
Have you seen her stuff, man? Oh, my gosh.
Yeah, I saw a recent sculpture she did of, what was it, the lamb with, or the, what was that? Something with 10 horns on it.
Yeah, that was a lamb, and then there was like a head and like all this crazy. I mean, not crazy. It was phenomenal. It's like, wow, you made
very
that.
Good job.
It's tremendous. It's like totally, you know, sell it in a studio quality type of stuff. Anyway, it was just awesome to see all the talent that you folks have out there, and that's why we're together, right, as a church, to put it all together and make the body work. Yeah. As it's supposed to.
Hint, hint, Miranda. Maybe you should start selling some of that.
Hint, hint. Amen. Hint, hey, Sandra. God bless you. Yeah. So wherever you're watching us, we thank you. We love you. We're giving you virtual hugs and fist bumps. And that's the point of it, is to make it available to as wide as an audience as we can. We've got it streaming to all the ETC platforms tonight. So no excuses, right? Definitely know what's going on if you tune in. Obviously we've got, it's pretty much the same, but we've got some stuff to go through, and I think it's good to take stock and be a steward you know, just let everyone inside, the inside baseball, as it were, to how it's going. I'm doing great, Isaac. Just a little feeling like a nerd these days, but that's okay. It's all right. My wife still likes me. In fact, she said that's why I married you, because you're a nerd.
You know, that's the most important thing, right?
Nothing else really matters, truly. And she made me chili, so we're good. We are good to go. Crumble little tortillas in there, right? We're good. I don't even need the beans. Do you like the no bean chili?
Well, I'll do it both. I like the beans and the beef in it, but
gotta have the meat, obviously.
Ground beef is great, or ground pork is really good in there too, like sausage.
All of that.
So good.
All the meats. Yeah. Yeah, I'm finding like I don't need the beans. Beans are fine, but give me the hot sauce. Okay. Well, and Chris would know a little bit about that if you've seen.
I'll put little habanero peppers in there. You chop those up like little bits. You put that in with it.
Yeah, I hear you're into that. The hotter, the better.
It's kind of nice.
Put it on video. Yeah, if you don't know Chris's YouTube channel, go check it out, and you'll see some real embarrassing times with him and his children.
Yeah,
and some hot, tasty stuff.
You know, they still got to wax my chest. I haven't done it yet, so I've been really putting that off. I keep getting people remind me periodically that I have to do that.
My dad, no, wait a minute. My dad used to tell me every time he ate something that was kind of spicy or basically anything, he said that puts hair on your chest. So wait, you're saying you got to take it off now?
Oh, yeah. They got to rip it off because I failed. So I'm going to have to do a redemption video of that one chip challenge, the Pocky one chip.
Which you failed miserably.
I failed miserably the first go around, hence the chest hair removal.
Right. But, well, you do need to have punishment of some kind.
Yeah.
Amen. Well, thankfully, our father's not that way. He's very forgiving. He's not going to make us do that kind of stuff.
What did he ask?
Yeah, right. So get your prayer request in right now. We want to get going here and talk to the Lord a little bit in prayer time. And Chris, it's up to you, brother. If you have a song to sing, if it's on your heart to do so, let's do it. If not, we'll just proceed.
Yeah, you know what? I'll do one song tonight. I haven't done anything in a while here musically with ETC, so we'll do one, and hopefully my internet connection holds out well. But take the next couple of minutes as we sing. Everybody knows the song. I'm going to just play How Great Thou Art. Everybody knows it. So take this next little bit, and if you have a prayer request, go ahead and put it in the comments section right here on YouTube and Facebook at endtime.church. Put it in the app, and we'll take a look at that, and we'll pray over those things after we take this moment for worship. So, Father, I thank you, God, just for the opportunity, Lord, to just come together with your people. Lord, as we sing, you know, How Great Thou Art, God, help us to see the greatness of you in our lives, God. Whether it had been a revelation of your greatness today, whether it's something that we've known for a while, God, as we sing this song, Lord, Holy Spirit, I just ask that you would bring this stuff to our memory. Lord, may our worship tonight in this moment, God, may it be a pleasing incense to you, a pleasing aroma to you, Father. In Jesus' name. Right, guys. So wherever you're at in the world today, no matter what country, what continent, whatever it is, wherever you're at, we all know how great thou art. So let's all sing this to the Lord together. Oh, Lord, my God. When I hit on awesome wonder, consider all the world thy hand hath made. I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder. Thy power throughout the universe display. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art. How great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art. How great thou art. And when I see that God, his Son, not sparing, sent him to die, I scarce can take it. That on the cross, my burden gladly buried, he bled and died to take away my sin. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art. How great thou art. Then sings my soul, Savior God, to thee. How great thou art. How great thou art. When Christ shall come with shouts of acclamation to take me home, what joy shall fill my heart. Then I shall bow in humble adoration, and there proclaim, oh my God, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art. How great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art. How great thou art. Sing that verse again. When Christ shall come with shouts of acclamation to take me home, what joy shall fill my heart. Then I shall bow in humble adoration, and there proclaim, oh my God, how great thou art. Sing, church. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. how great thou art. How great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art. How great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art. How great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art. How great thou art.
Father, you are great, God. You are great and greatly to be praised, God. You are worthy of all of our praise, God, all of our worship. You are our King of kings, our Lord of lords, God. And we just lift you up tonight. We bless you. Lord, I just want to pray right now, God, for Laura right now dealing with COVID and Bobby as well, who has an unspoken prayer request, and also for Leah to come back to you, God. Lord, COVID-19, God, you know what's going on. You know what's ravaging this world, God. You know what's a plague, God, that is happening. Lord, you know everything to do with it. You know all aspects of this, God. And so I just want to lift up specifically Laura right now for healing, God. Your word declares, but by your stripes we were healed. Jesus, you bore on your body the stripes that paid for the healing of everyone who has COVID and any other sickness tonight that may be there. So Holy Spirit, I just ask, Lord, that you would just come into Laura's room where she's at right now and just begin to minister healing to her, that her lungs would begin to clear up, that the coughing would begin to clear up, that the congestion would begin to clear up, God, that the body aches and the sores and the headaches would begin to go and disappear right now in Jesus' name. For your word declares healing. When your word declares that by your stripes we were healed, your blood speaks that better word. Lord, right now, that unspoken prayer request for Bobby, God, you know what that is, Lord. You know what that need may be, God. And so whatever it is, Holy Spirit, we just ask that you just begin to move in that situation. Just ask what you do, dispatch angels to just minister to that Bobby right now. And Lord, I just want to pray for Leah, God. She has walked away from you. She has turned her back. She has backslidden, Lord. And I would ask, Lord, and I pray, God, that you would send ambassadors of your kingdom, Lord, to cross her path and to begin to sow into her life again, to begin to water, Lord, that seed that's in her life, God. She knows the truth. And Lord, I pray that those ambassadors that would come into her life, God, those sons and daughters of yours, that as they minister to her, God, that she would look back just as the prodigal son did and see the home that he left, God. And that Laura, too, would see the home that she has left. And she would say that it was so much better in my father's house and that she would come back to you. Whatever's holding her back and keeping her from coming back, Lord, we just come against that in Jesus' name. Lord God, I just want to just pray for the entire church tonight, everyone here that's gathered, whether they're watching on YouTube, whether you're watching on Facebook or endtime.church, or whether they're on the app or wherever it may be, God, whether they're watching live now or they're going to watch later on, Father, that would I just ask the Holy Spirit that you would just move in their lives. Lord, we need a new revelation, a fresh revelation of who you are. Lord, I just ask that you would birth a hunger in each one of our lives to seek your face instead of your hand, that we would press into who you are, God, not seek your blessings, not seek the benefit of being your children, though those things were there, but that we would seek your face, God, to seek your favor, that we would seek to become more like you in our thoughts and our words and our deeds, that we would seek to take on the characteristic traits of who you are, God, more and more. And Lord, as Pastor Manti gets ready to come back, I just pray, God, that whatever he's bringing tonight, God, we're talking about the state of the church, God, that people would see the condition and the state of the church, to see the vision, where we're going. And Lord, that Pastor Manti would cast vision in a way, God, that we would catch it. We thank you, God. We bless you. We lift you up in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Amen, brother. Thank you, friend. Love you, Mr. Anderson. Man, honestly, every week, every time we get on and do this, no matter who's bringing the message or whatever at a given time, just so amazed and thankful and grateful for how great he is, how faithful our Father is to provide what he has established, where he directs and where he tells you to go, he will provide. In those circumstances, that's just the way it is. I hope we know that. Maybe this can be a miniature testimony of that tonight. And before we get going here, I just wanted to bring on a comment by Michelle, who said something very true. And it's just an example of what I'm talking about, which is, she says, how powerful it is to think people all over the world are singing at the same time. Yes, yes. So what this is about tonight is not strictly a message or teaching, but it does, to me, invokes Titus when it says, for an overseer or bishop or elder, your translation may say, for an overseer as God's steward must be above reproach. He must not be arrogant or quick-tempered, drunkard or violent or greedy for gain, but hospitable, lover of good, self-controlled, upright, holy, and disciplined. He must hold firm to the trustworthy word as taught, so that he may be able to give instruction in sound doctrine and also to rebuke those who contradict, etc., etc., right? So that's how I see my role. In this, in that, he has had this planted now almost 4 years ago, with Jake McCandless and myself way back when, right? And, it's been quite the journey. So, and I also, of course, think of who is the faithful and wise steward, that provides food in due season. And that's obviously not only a statement of expectation or responsibility, but prophetic utterance by the Lord Jesus. So let's get that in mind as we do this. The state of the church address. Yes, my fellow end time churchians. I think this was important to do. Let me change that background real quick. That's better. Because a lot of folks don't know. We just don't know what the deal is. We see, hey, this is a platform. You can go there and you can talk, or you can, you know, post and smile and have prayer said for you and with you. And sometimes there's cool things on a Monday night or whatever. But you don't really, maybe it's not much more than that, etc. So this is truly the state of the church from the perspective of the back end, okay, the administrative side, and what I can see as an overview. And as Chris said, as the vision goes, hey, Brother Bill, welcome, friend. As vision goes, I think it's really important that we all be on the same page. Duh. So let's see what we find. All right. Where we are exactly? Where are we as a congregation? By the way, this is a little more limited in audience as far as where we're streaming this to tonight. So I'm expecting many more to see it afterwards than live, but that's okay. We're going to the End Time Church Facebook group, which we normally don't go to. A lot of folks don't pick up on it there. As well as to, obviously, our new version of our website. Okay, here's what's been going on the past couple of months, really, maybe even years. So we know that there's this great opportunity. There's a need for the church to unite worldwide. There's a need for the body of Christ to come together because, for many reasons, but many of us have found each other here because we, whether our local congregations don't talk about it or we've been, you've had just really negative experience when we're trying to talk about the future in terms of what the scripture says and what we should be expecting, what we should be preparing for, you know, all those Bible prophecy types of things. We can't even have a conversation half the time, you know, with anybody in your church, much less those who are chosen to oversee that church. So that's why many of us are together. But some of us, like we have brothers in, you know, India and in the Arabian Peninsula and so forth, that don't have many other believers, period, who think about these things. So we found each other that way. So I just praise God for that. Okay. So there's technology that we're taking advantage of to do that. We're not going to cede this ground to the devil. The enemy doesn't own the internet. They don't own social, you know, he doesn't own social media. These are tools that God has provided the church to be the church in these days. I'm absolutely, totally convinced that that's true. Well, all our leaders here can tell you the same thing. And what is again, like we talked about last week, what's the leader in the end times? It's just a servant is willing to do what needs to be done. That's it. And so I think many of us watching fit the mold. Okay, so what happened recently and why you've seen the changes that you have is the previous website database email host that we had been using, and there's nothing wrong with them. There was not a problem per se, but it was getting a little expensive because we have to be very frugal, okay, right now. The past, you know, year plus or more, it's just been, you know what, we really got to get a little leaner and meaner as far as our output and how we're stewarding this operation, right? What do we need to do? Lots of things are nice to do or nice to have, etc. So anyways, we were using a Christian company called Tithely, which I've used forever with Wings of the Eagle to collect donations. So because they let you do it for free. And they're a Christian company, and they serve churches, ministries. That's what they do. That's what their business is. And they charge the same as everyone else does for processing your credit card transactions and stuff. It was no more than that. So I feel very comfortable with that end of it, and I'd be happy to remain with that for your tithes and offerings and gifts. By the way, just ask the Lord what you should give tonight, and please do so tonight or whenever he tells you to. That they offer a suite of things that I figured would be a little more interactive than they were. For example, the website that you're probably used to, that's you're not seeing tonight, that was part of it. The database, in other words, everyone that contacted us at any point to email or, you know, one of the services or any point of contact that we've made over the years, it just went into this giant CHMS system. If you don't know what that means, don't worry about it. It's just a big database of names and address, you know, email addresses. If you had a phone number on file, all that stuff, just say who's who and where you live, just records of who is part of the church at any point. That costs money to store these things. Does it talk to the other systems, right? There's different things like text messages and blah, blah, blah. Emails. Every time you get an email, recently you might have gotten one that we'll talk about here in a second. But anyway, all these things were fine. But the point is, they weren't perfect. Obviously, nothing's perfect. But it was about $100 a month to do all those things. Not unreasonable to have all those things in one thing. It's not absurd. But we just had to find another way. So I've been on the lookout for that. We found a way. An alternative way. So there's no reason to do two things. So as far as that goes, the previous email system database website is no more with Tithely, but obviously the donations part of it still is. No change there. No problem. The current app that you may be watching this on right now, called the End Time Church app, everyone basically loves it. I love it. It's groundbreaking, literally. We were one of the first customers ever. We're definitely the first customer of this company called Disciple out in the United Kingdom in England. They were basically working with bands like the Rolling Stones and you know, kind of like smaller businesses. They never had a church sign on to their thing to use for anything. We were that, right? We were the, not the experiment, but the forerunners in that, or pioneers. And so it's been awesome, okay? And again, their pricing is not bad at all. In fact, they charge double what they charge us to a new customer. Great, fantastic. But problem is, it's still a lot based on what we've had coming in. So at the end of this term, we paid up. Our bill is always come due in June. So at the latest, by June, we're just not going to renew that because we found, again, a better alternative by $1,000 a year, to be honest with you. $1,000 a year. The End Time Church app costs $2,500 every year, no matter what. And every single year we've done it, how long have we had it now? 18, like 3 or 4 years. We did it on faith. In other words, I always took the credit card that we have for business purposes, Wings of the Eagle / End Time Church, one card, charge this, and then I'll ask for the money later. And hopefully it comes, right? And usually it took about 6 months or more to get, and it, you know, we just barely got in there. So nobody wants to do that. Nobody wants to be hounded for, you know, donations all the time because there's an app cost out there. I don't want to do it. I don't want to ask for it. I don't want you to hear about it. If there's any way to cut that down, I always think, well, the first opportunity we have to make this better, I'm going to take it. And we should. And that finally happened in November. Because there are alternatives out there. There are apps that kind of do the community thing, but not many, but a few. One of them was even a Christian company. Tithely could not do what we wanted at all, even though, you know, they would have been on the inexpensive side. Subsplash is like the biggest one right now. They are way too expensive for what we wanted. It would be more expensive than what we were paying. So I always look to obviously have a Christian company first, but if it didn't work out, it didn't work out. So we finally got a great combination of all the things that we're looking for in one. And to me, as an admin, as a behind the scenes person, this is like heavenly. This is such a godsend because now you're not going different places. For example, you have, if you're on our app and if you've given a donation and if you've submitted a prayer request through a form, you're in three different places. Your information. And we've got to figure out who's doing what and when, and do they still want to be contacted? And boy, did I just contact them three times for no reason, right? Stuff like that. That's just one of the many annoyances that come with that territory. Anyways, point is, hallelujah, praise God, we found a more cost-effective and streamlined host for all those things. And then we're going to, in a second, I'll get to the second part, which is current members and or subscribers to our different channels, for the most part, are not contributing. And I don't mean just financially, just in general. We'll get to that in a second, okay? All right. Let me zoom out here. First thing you'll notice, I just want to go through a few. Basically, I spent all day screenshotting and stitching together screenshots and putting arrows on stuff. All right. So if you go to the endtime.church site, I don't want to say don't go to YouTube or Facebook to watch us. That's fine. But we really want to go here and share this. Okay. It's important that we actually come to the website itself that we operate and not depend on Facebook or YouTube. We're always going to do it because that's where the people are, who maybe the stragglers, the new person, you know, who just randomly come in, or maybe they just want to check it out or something and they don't want to go to a website. Okay. But if you're, you know, here, it's good that you're on the website or on our app. Okay. Just say no more. Here's the homepage. You're watching the live video now, which is that the red area. And then you see where you saw before on our old page, you have it a spot for contact us for prayer. You still have that. The give now, obviously, for giving whatever the Lord lays on your heart to give us or share with the church. There it is. It's still there. It says give now. Watch previous services. Right below this screenshot, there's a playlist of from our YouTube channel for all the previous services going all the way back to the 4 years ago. So utilize that. What you're also going to see is something cool. Now, right now, if you're just arriving on the site and you never logged in or anything, you'll see a button that says contact us. That's actually a chat button that'll always be on the site for any reason. But here's something cool. And I just wanted to, this is where I said earlier about apologizing for an email. The website is endtime.church. Michelle, endtime.church. Just like you see at the top there, that's it. It's not .com, it's .church. Justin, brother, we'll be praying for you, man. You've got COVID now as well, man. Were you just recovering from your like your ankle or something? Or your leg? Was that Justin? Okay, so, well, praise God, man. Thank you. So if you go to the site, you will see a blank thing that says log in at the upper right-hand corner. You're going to want to do this. Now, I didn't know how it would work exactly, so I apologize. I didn't realize that there's so many features now that we can put in together to one thing that it would be so efficient, but it was. So what we did is I just combined all the database information that we had previously, right, in the Tithely locations, whether it be the site or email contacts and all that stuff, forms, all that stuff. So put it all together. And there's an aspect to our site now where if you are a member of the site, that doesn't mean you paid money to get in and now you're a member of the church. It just means you're a member because you signed in. You make a sign in and boom, you can get in. Once you hit that login button, you're going to see these two options, one of these two. First, the default is login because hopefully you're already a member. You just log yourself in, or you can hit, it says new to this site, sign up. Then you'll see the one on the right, already a member, log in. Anyway, you got the two options, okay? Sign up or log in. Once you do that, you'll get an email sent to you. This is what you guys, a lot of you, everyone basically, I took the liberty of, as it turns out, sending you all this automatic. So you don't have to actually fill in this request to log in. You already got one of these in your inbox, assuming you gave us a proper email address when you contacted us whenever, however long ago. Okay. So you should already have this. And I've got several questions today. Hey, was this spam? Is this really from End Time Church? Yes, yes, yes. It's us. Don't worry. It's not spam. Not a problem. Okay. Yes, this is what this was about. So what I tried to do, what I didn't realize you'd get emails automatically, was I just took the full list of everyone we had. There were about 700 names on there, believe it or not. And then just said, yeah, I'm going to make them all members automatically. That's what the option was. Make them members. Sweet. Everyone's a member. Don't even have to do anything. Well, you do, because here's your email. Okay. All you want to do is confirm that. Yep. That's my email. When you see, what is this Wix thing? Wix is the company that's hosting all the stuff for us. I have used Wix for wingsoftheeagle.com for 5 years or more. Yeah, a long time now. And they've been great. It's been great. I've never had a problem, never had hardly any downtime. I mean, nothing that I could really think of to complain about, which is tough in the technical world. They've been fantastic, okay? And now they are adding these awesome aspects to themselves, which is members only things on your site, which is what you're seeing now. This is one of those things. Online courses can be hosted through your site. Events like just online events like we do with Alfadi. You ever see that? You ever hear me talk about that? We could do this through this. All these things now can come about, as well as an app option, a branded app option, which means we can have the inexpensive, I don't know if it'll be better, but it'll be good, and it'll be all tied together. And the email system, all tied together, so we don't get duplications and all that stuff. Super, super, I think, very exciting stuff for an online church, because that's what we are. All right, so point is, yes, this email is from us. It's good. Don't worry about Wix. Wix is great. Just confirm if you want to. Now, this is funny. This is like the first thing I took this morning. Here's the chat option that you, by the way, this is a picture of yours truly with three fingers on a keyboard, trying to get three keys at one time to take the snapshot. And then with my hand over the exact right place to point at what I want you to see. Of course, I'm thinking, duh, I just put an arrow in there later. Okay. So the chat feature, a lot of you guys, some of you have figured it out already. If you're watching on our website, at least the desktop, you know, computer version, not your phone version that I know of. But at least the main website on the computer version or the tablet. If you hover, as I said at the beginning, if you hover over, you'll see you can chat right in there. If you're signed in as a member, you can sign in right there and start chatting away. So I'm in there, Taryn. Was commenting earlier, and some other folks. Yeah. Anyways, it works and it's happening now. So you can do it. It's a little different than it was. Okay. I understand there's a little learning curve in there, but to me, that's awesome. And you can do it right there. All you have to do is sign in as a member and you can be on every one of our live streams on Monday night. You don't have to do it every week, right? You won't get an email every week or any of that stuff. It's just once you do it, you're in. And you'll see it right there on the side. Okay. Also, now, when you sign in as a member of the site, you will see two things become available to you. Number one, there's one of the tabs that says member groups. Member groups, you'll probably recognize, looks a lot like our app, if you've ever seen it. Yeah, that's right, because they'll be tied together. So you don't even need the app with you in your phone. If you don't want to, you could use the web version, which is right here. All right. So you'll see these, be able to join as a member. And then you'll see the chat box went from, what was the original? Contact us in the bottom right. Now it's changed to member chat. There you see that? It's right there too. Members chat. When you're signed in, what do you mean, members chat? Yeah, you can actually talk to any other member of End Time Church right there. You hit new chat, and then a list of people will pop up. You can have a group chat even. I'm not even sure how it all works yet, but it's there. It's super cool. Anyway, these are the things that will change once you get in as a member. Now, you're saying, okay, well, what about, don't we have an app for our phone still and our tablets? Yes. Yes. Okay. You're automatically added to that. You're automatically in that. Now, however, until we actually go ahead and make the purchase for the year for our own version of the app, it's going to be using the Wix store to get it. Now, nobody wants that. It looks weird. It's complicated. Nobody wants to say, go to Wix to get the End Time Church app. Okay. But what's going to happen is if you join in this one, automatically you're going to be, it'll take one click to go to the new one once we purchase it. So it's super, super easy. There are how many people in here now? 688 since today. All that is was automatically being added. You didn't choose to even be in there. You're there. Okay. So there's a mobile version that will become our app when we make the purchase and make it fully End Time Church stuff. Okie dokie. Does that, hopefully that's not too confusing. So don't worry when you see this. Again, don't worry when you see this. All right, now we're back to the main thrust of it. All right, current app host, again, will not be renewed in June. That means, yes, the current End Time Church app will be going away, but everyone that we have a record for now is automatically in this new one, and then when we make the switch and actually purchase the new End Time Church version of the app, then you'll be notified direct. Kosher? Okay. And we save $1,000. $1,000. So it's $1,500. What does that mean? That means we have to pay $1,500 here between now and June. But then we're good for the year. But see, this shouldn't be a problem. It's not a problem. We've got 800, 700 people already in our little app. The new one. And I'll go over some numbers here that you can see what I'm talking about. Hell, none of this should be a problem ever. We have a new digital home with all these things. So thank God for Wix. And as of November, we've got all these different functions in it that are really going to serve Jesus. We're going to serve the body of Christ even better and more streamlined, lean and mean. Okay. Here's what this last point means. It says current subscribers or members for the most part are not contributing. And that's in every way, in fellowship, in discipleship, right? In being with your fellow believers, helping them, ministering to them, being ministered to by them, all that stuff, volunteering your time. Now, again, this is not a guilt trip. There's an old saying, you know, 20% of the people do 80% of the work. It's even more extreme with End Time Church. Okay. Truly. And it is what it is. I'm just telling you, a few people do a whole lot of stuff here. A lot of stuff that they don't have to be doing, and they have families and they have jobs and they have, I'm the only full-time minister. Okay. I'm the only one that does this and nothing else. I'm associate pastor at Iron Faith Fellowship, Wilmington, Delaware, and pastor here. That's what I do. It's all I do. I depend on God and he defends me, full time for now for 3 years. Plus 8, 9, 11, almost 4. And that's just the way it is. So this is what we need to do. Volunteering time and financially. Okay. So all those ways the folks who are connecting with End Time Church aren't contributing anything. Here's what I mean. This is a snapshot of our current End Time Church app. You see currently 561 community members at the bottom. These are all a bunch of metrics here. 125 monthly active users. That's pretty okay. That means this past month, there's 125 people that are active in their accounts. In a given week, there are 32. Every day, there are 32. So the same 32 people are in there every day. Praise God, okay? But obviously, it's not 125, and it's not 561. And here's the thing, and they're all registered, which, great, that means we all have valid email addresses in there. This is the amount that are on iOS, your Apple devices versus Android here, versus people who just use the web version. That's all fine, all well and good. And this number, 561, was a lot more. It was well over 2,000. You say, whoa, Pastor Manti, what happened? We give them the boot because they don't come back. If you didn't log in for 6 months, you're automatically removed. It means you're not interested. It means you thought it was cool. You did it for one day and then you left forever. Sorry. We send you an email, say, hey, if you want to come back in, you got to re-sign back in. Otherwise, we're going to delete your account. And that's fine. You can sign up again. It's not like you're banned. But this number, the point is, this number is as current as possible. And if we never deleted anybody for inactivity, it would be at least 4 times to 5 times higher. The point is the inactivity. Okay. The point is the non engagement. I don't have an explanation for that. I'm just telling you this is the facts. Here's a snapshot of our YouTube channel. Current subscribers, 776. Looks good. In fact, this little graph shows you the whole lifetime, the whole lifespan from 2018, the beginning. Here's 2019, right? 2020, 2021. Now it's a steady growth upwards. That's great. But 776 subscribers? We don't have 776 people engaging with us. But they're subscribed to our YouTube channel. This is our Facebook page. Total likes, 792. Guys, trust me, there's a little bit of overlap, but mostly YouTube and Facebook are different audiences. It just so happens they're around the same number. Most of these people are different. So now we have 792 people who like our Facebook page. And by the way, I didn't show, and this is our whole life, going back to the earliest date I could, which is January 2020. So the past year. And so there's a dip, it ebbs and flows. Unlike, I don't like what he said there. Oh, I like that. I don't like that. There are 100 more people that just follow our page than like it. And why would you follow End Time Church and not like the page? Basically, you're spying. Right? You want to see what's going on, but you don't want to be counted as a liker so they know who you are. So lurkers, at least, probably spying. That's fine. They're going to hear the gospel if they're spying, okay? But just saying, this is the reality. So again, almost 800 folks. We are not getting engagement from 800 folks. Why would you like the page? This is our Facebook group, different from a Facebook page. This is supposed to have interaction, and this is kind of what our app is supposed to do anyway, but this still has 334 members. In fact, you see some familiar faces down here, if you look carefully. It's Pastor Randy. I see Chad Harvey, et cetera. Oh, I think I see Roland. Praise God. Anyways, that's 334 people. These are hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of folks everywhere. And most of them are, you know, they come from different places. The End Time Church app versus, you know, an email list versus our YouTube channel versus the Facebook page. All these avenues are there. And some people are on all of them, right? But most people are not. You can have a guesstimation about how many folks are actually in the orbit, right? Or actually it kind of involved or kind of like what we're doing, but never actually say anything, never actually get involved, never actually do the work of the church. How do we do that? We need you. That's the point. So all things considered, we take a look at all that together. It seemed to me like a slight rebranding was in order. So that's why you're going to see this at times. You see this on the new homepage. And as dear sister Micah said, I like it, but I kind of miss the flame. You don't have to miss the flame. That's the old, not the old logo, the original logo. It's still alive, okay? It still exists. You'll see it. At times, but, I did a lot of churches use flames. We're Pentecost, right? We get it. It's a Christian symbol. Especially in the, you know, the charismatic Pentecostal side of Holy Spirit lovers. Yes, it's awesome. We love it. Flames cool. But a lot of people use it just like the cross. Obviously we love the cross. We preach nothing but Jesus and Christ, you know, Christ and Him crucified. Cross is everything. But everyone uses it. So what is this about? Well, I'll leave that to you. But to me, it conveys destiny. Destiny, the destination of the End Time Church. That just doesn't mean you people who are watching this second. It doesn't mean our little group on the internet. It means the entire church at the time of the end. All believers who will stand, who will listen to the Holy Spirit, to listen to our shepherd, to go where he says, do what he says, and do what needs to be done to fulfill the scriptures. That points to that. And that great blazing sun rising over whatever mountain you can think of scripturally. That's what it is. All right. That's our destiny. That's our destiny. And yeah, it applies to you. Sure, it does. It applies to me. Yes, it does. Why did I write the book called Flee to the Mountains? Why do I have my ministry called Wings of the Eagle? What? Okay. It's not that hard to figure out. Why are we launching hopefully a tour company to take folks to this part of the world that is underserved. Okay. It's all about that. Right. And of course, those who are involved with Jacob's Refuge, we've talked about that a few times here on this service at the End Time Church service. There's now a public phase of, and while I'm thinking of it, this is not part of the plan tonight, but you saw this weekend, you saw yesterday and the day before, how much the Jews are hated because they're Jews. Why did this guy break into a synagogue and take hostages? And praise God, he didn't kill anyone. But he would have. And why did he do little details like why did he choose that place? Why did he want this terrorist woman to be released from Texas jail, or the Lady Al-Qaeda woman who said very openly she did what she did because the Jews, the Zionist synagogues are the ones that are responsible for the evil out of America, the Zionist synagogues? Why do you think he went, this guy, when he took the hostage, had the rabbi of that synagogue in Texas, why do you think he had them call a synagogue in New York and talk to their rabbi? This other rabbi had no idea who anything was. They had no idea. I think it was a she. Had no idea who this guy was. No idea who this other congregation, this other synagogue was. It's because this evil man who broke in and took the hostages thought that they were Zionist synagogues that conspire together. Don't listen to this mental health business. This is what Satan has done. This is what the deception is. And we can fight all day and all night about every other issue. The fact is, and Dalton Thomas had a really perfect way to put this a couple weeks ago on one of his videos, is that as someone who has ministered and lives in the Middle East and has ministered in very inhospitable places for Christians in Syria, in Iraq, in the Muslim world, right in the heart of Turkey and right in the heart of the Muslim world, Muslims, including ISIS, he says, don't hate Christians for being Christians. They really couldn't care less. Sometimes they get upset when you proselytize, when you give them the gospel. But what they really, really hate at their core, what they really want to get rid of this world, is only if you stand with the Jews. Only if you make friends with the Jews and all of a sudden you're a Zionist too. That's when they want to kill you. I think there's a message in there, friends. There's a message in there for the church. That everything else is deception. Don't avert your gaze anywhere. Don't look anywhere else. This is all the place. You want to be in the middle of the end times. You want to be in the middle of the persecution. You want to see what's really going on. You want to see through the principalities and powers. You want to see through the spiritual haze of the world. Love the Jews. Stand with them. Be willing to give your life for them, even though they don't even like you. or don't know you. That will hurt hell. That will get you in the crosshairs of the devil. And quite frankly, that's where we want to be. Amen. He can't hurt us. Don't be afraid of what man can do to you. Don't be afraid. The devil can't touch you. It doesn't matter. So that's what the logo is about. And it's different. All right. So finally, hopefully we got a good, summary of where we are and what needs to change. Hopefully, right? We see what needs to change and the changes are being made, at least somewhat, but the rest of it's on you guys. The rest of it's on us as a group, as a church. Where are we going? We're getting leaner and meaner. Leaner and meaner. That's just my phrase. I identify with it. I know what it means. Think of it as even in terms of your flesh and your body, right? If you are overweight or if you shouldn't be doing this or that, lean and mean's the order of the day. A mean doesn't mean cruel. It doesn't mean mean. You know what I mean. Stop saying mean. Laser focused. I believe that God is doing this with End Time Church. He's saying, you know what? There's all this stuff is good. You had a lot of good ideas, maybe even some things that failed or some things that you just couldn't get done because you didn't have help. But that's not the laser focus we want. Laser focus. Straight in God's face, looking at him, seek his face. Chris was right on in the prayer. Lord, that we would seek your face, not that we would ask for blessing, not that we would ask for anything other than you. We want you. We want to see you. We want to feel you. We want your presence with us, even now. That's what should drive us. That's what should make us say Maranatha, because we can't stand to be without you. Right? That's it. That's the laser focus. And we are to be laser focused on what our mission is. Our mission is to provide an online church, an online gathering of believers. Whether you believe it's legitimate or not, you're going to get to it eventually. And yes, we're biblically ordained pastoral leaders. Yep, I am. Yep, Chris Anderson is. Yep, Pastor Randy is. Not the most popular dudes in the world, but we did it God's way. So stay on task. Stay laser focused. You have to provide. He was crystal clear. And we've seen the fruit of this starting. Hopefully more than starting, which is provide. He told me, look at Malachi 3:16, provide that place where my people can speak to one another, even if they're in different continents. Provide it. Provide the place. Facilitate that communication. That's what I'm here to do, guys. That's what I'm here to do. I'm not anything other than a facilitator. Make the connection. Call it networking if you want. Call it a point guard of the basketball team if you want. The point guard usually isn't the big scorer, right? He's finding the guys who are open. He's finding the big scorers. The big man underneath, one who rocked the rim. Okay, that's what we want to do. Rock Satan's world. Okay, so that's what my role is. And other people have roles too. Great, let's go. Let's focus. Let's do this. Let's provide this online communication tool, whether it be the app, whether it be the site, whether it be secret missions, whether it be tour groups, whether it be books, whether it be whatever, courses, whatever. But don't get distracted from the core mission of providing that place, provide that place where my people can speak to one another, facilitate that communication, give them the tools. So I hope this is it. Point is, out of all that great sounding stuff, none of it's going to happen if you don't engage. All of us engage. Not just agree, not just like, share like crazy, tell that you are proud to be part of this. Tell everyone in your church. Tell all the groups that you're in. Don't let this, the church is not a tribal thing where you can't, oh, I can't tell these group, you know, about this group. tell your Zoom Bible studies that you're in, tell your other churches that you're with, tell your other ministries, hey, you know what? Other guys are really big and they make millions. They don't need you to share their stuff. Share our stuff. And again, it's not our stuff. It's the point is, hey, this is different. This is not consumerism. This is not, hey, we've got content for you to share. We've got content for you to watch. We want you to participate. This is a body. This is the body of Christ from all over the world. God is going to use this. But we need to do it together. You are not a spectator if you're a part of this church. I'm not going to allow that. Chris is not going to allow that. We're not going to let you be comfortable in that. Randy, sure as heck, is not going to allow you to be comfortable sitting around. God has called you to do something. He has saved you for action. He's saved you to serve the body of Christ, preach the gospel to the lost. Healing, deliverance, salvations, yes, and giving your own life until he returns. That's why we're here. But without you, all of you, all of us, you saw the numbers, guys. If a $1,500 bill comes in, we have literally 1,500 people plus that are watching or can have subscribed, know we're there, know we're what we're doing, can be part of an app, can be part of this, that, and the other thing. Cake. Boom. One day, $1 each, it's done. For example. And by the way, it would be a lot more than that. Now, all of a sudden, we got tremendous opportunities if we're in it together. That's all. And yes, I know we've all got other things. Trust me, I know. But if God's in it, let's give it our best shot. That is the state of the End Time Church on this January 17th, 2022. And I'm just about ready to head on out of here and hang out with my family for a couple hours. If there's any questions, now is the time. Hey, Maureen. Hey, there's Pastor Anderson. What's up, brother?
A couple hours, man. It's bedtime. What are you talking about?
I can't put him to bed now anymore. I wish. You'll get there, man. You'll see.
Shoot, I was taking a nap at 6 o'clock so I can have the energy to be here tonight.
Well, you went right over the age of staying awake late. Yeah. Now you need a nap to get to bedtime.
That's right.
No. I've got a 15-year-old, man. It's not happening. I still remember what it was like to me. Mom, leave me alone. I'll be fine. Anywho, yeah. So that's it, man. That's it. Were those clear? I mean, like, was that confusing? Were those too many numbers and statistics, or was that?
It's pretty laid out there. It's pretty straightforward. And, you know, like you said, you know, nobody in leadership here is going to advocate for complacency, you know, just sitting back and doing nothing. Like, you know, it's all about action. And in honesty, if you don't know how you can be involved, let us know. We'll certainly help you out. We'll give you some ideas. And it's not necessarily even just about being involved at End Time Church. We certainly want that. But we also want you to be active and involved in your own community, right? Whether it's in your home church or whether it's if you don't go to a home church for whatever reason, we certainly want to encourage that. But in your own neighborhood, with your own neighbors, the people right next door. I mean, we want to help you start Bible studies in your neighborhood, you know, whatever it may be. And I mean, we're not about putting in necessarily saying this is an End Time Church thing. Like, we just want the body of Christ to be active, to be doing what God has called you to do, to help grow you and mentor you in those giftings and those talents and whatever it is.
Right.
You know, we just want to see God glorified in your life as well as what we do. So.
Amen. Amen. There's no demarcation, right? If you're in the body or you're not. Yes. Thank you for putting a point on that. That's exactly right. That's exactly right. And by the way, we're not only going to not leave you alone in complacency, but hopefully we're modeling that. In that we are not complacent folks. Better or for worse, right? We're always trying to hit it. To God forbid that we get complacent.
Problem is sometimes we just burn the candle at both ends and get burned out and have to step away for a little bit just to get some rest. But, you know, that's actually a good thing too. It's called a sabbatical.
Amen. And I did that not too long ago, right? Yeah. Yeah. But right. So the point is, we're not like trying to be a hypocrite and say, oh, do something I'm not willing to do. We are all of that mindset. Everyone who's has any type of leadership here, it's because they're not willing to be complacent. They feel the urge. They feel the fire in the bones to do that because they know the Lord is coming. And he wants to be known. He wants us to show that, you know, we love him. And Jesus is the Son of God, and we're going to show what he's equipped us to do. Anyway, yeah, you got it, man. Oh, that's it, guys. Hopefully that's helpful. Please do reach out. Now we just got another avenue. You saw, you can just hit the button on our website, whether it's a contact form or a chat, live chat, whatever. It's super easy. Just say, hey, okay, I'm here. You know, help. What do you need help with? What do you need prayer for? What do you need to contact us about? We're ready. And that's it. Done. Dunsky. Hang on. Maureen said something here on our app. By the way, Christopher Anderson now has a brand new video uploaded, which is What is the Gospel?
It took only a couple of weeks to get there, but
nobody had to know that. Right?
So I had to figure out how to get it off the phone on the computer.
Bro, I'm trying to cover for you here. Take the cover. Yes, it's here now. That's the important thing, right? It's all that matters. It's available now, so it's on the Start Here section of our app. If you don't know what the gospel is, or you don't think you can provide it in a straightforward, you know, succinct manner, watch that.
Pretty simple, right?
It's super simple, man. It truly is. Right. And Maureen is saying, I just want to say I am so grateful for this platform. Well, praise God for you. I left social media, and it's great to find like-minded fellow believers who love God and want to serve, who want to die to the flesh and get prepared for his coming. Yep, that's the beginning and the end of it. And that's the point too, right? We say that, oh, well, get off of godless social media. Okay, let's do that. But be serious about it. Don't flit around from one to the next. Well, I got a great new one, guys. Check this new social out. It's all full of believers, or it's all full of whatevers. Come on. Let's get serious. If we're serious about serving God, then let's do that. Let's do that. That's why it's important that it's I would say, you know, for Christians by Christians. Yeah, it's to serve in the church. It's to increase the church. It's to increase the kingdom of God. Bring in the family, right? Bring in more family members. That's what the Father wants. So let's be about it. Okay. That's it, friends. Good night to one and all. We love you so very much, and especially Christopher Anderson and his dulcet tones. Wonderful, wonderful stylings and profilings on the acoustic. Although he prefers the electric, I'm thinking.
On Sundays. So I played lead at church this past Sunday. I'm playing lead again this next Sunday, and then on rhythm electric, which normally when I do that, I have a really low-end crunch to it.
Yeah.
See, you got my black flying V with the skull tuning knobs on there and all that. Got my black strap with the bullet hole smiley face. And
hey, yeah, God forbid, I'm telling you, man, one day when I'm playing up there, you know, I'm drumming away, and every song turns into a hard rock song, no matter what it is. You know, Newsboys, that's as good as it gets. But anyways, yeah, one day we're going to get together, and we're going to make some beautiful music in person, even if it's in the kingdom. But hopefully not till then. But we'll see. All right, sir. I love you guys all. Let us know what you need. And Lord willing, we'll be back here next Monday night, as always, to gather as the End Time Church. We love you. We bless you. The Father keep you. Let his face shine upon you and give you that shalom that only he can provide. Amen. Bye.